Knowledge, they say, is power. See, if you don't have a knowledge, you will remain at the same spot. But the knowledge you have will move you, knowledge will make you ascend to another dimension. Oh God. If you don't have the knowledge that a bus stop is not in operation, you will stand there waiting for a bus to come. But in some bus stops, they'll say, this bus stop is not in operation. And someone that cannot read will just stay there and say, this 242 is not here yet. When is bus 56 going to come? And she cannot just read, or he cannot just read that it's written that a bus is not coming yet. The person will say, oh, let me wait for an hour. But someone that has knowledge, even if it's not written in that bus, at that bus stop, that there's the bus is out of order. If the bus stop is functioning well, someone that has knowledge in the presence of the fact that there's the bus stop is operating, and you wait for a bus for over an hour and you didn't see it. Some people now pick up their phone, knowing that the number of the bus itself is actually somewhere on the board. You can then call the office and ask, make an inquiry. I'm just calling to make an inquiry. I've been waiting at this bus stop for 2 hours and no bus seems to be coming. How everything is right? Is any bus coming on this path or not? So I can find my route. But some with that knowledge will stay at that same bus stop from 12 a.m. to 2 a.m. midnight. And possibly the touts will come there and meet her or him. And probably the person is killed. The person is murdered because of lack of knowledge. No wonder the Bible says in Hosea 4 verse 6 that my people perish because they lack knowledge. Amen. Amen. Now, what am I talking about? This passage you just read says, when a woman is in labor, she cries for pain. She's feeling pain. But the moment she gives birth, let her feel more ventilation. I think that's what she needs. The moment she feels, she gives birth to a child. Someone say breakthrough.
Breakthrough.
When someone is struggling to have a breakthrough, strength is used in that process. Energy is exhausted. And they begin to ask the woman to push and push. That means pray until something happens. The sickness of Christians today is that we don't have the strength to push. The problem of most believers is that when they push, and something is not happening yet, then they will call their friends and say, do you know any other medium? And they will go through another medium. If God tells them that what you're going through, I want to teach you a lesson in this experience, in this knowledge, or in these things you're going through, and God has pre-planned that you are to wait for 3 years, then when you seek for another medium, for that other medium, you might use 6 years, then you will come back to God's program and you'll say, can you please start from the beginning? Somebody shout a loud hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today, the topic of today's message says, I'm not going to tell you the topic now. I don't want to leak the secret so quick. Turn your Bible with me to the book of Psalm 102, verse 13. Psalm 102, verse 13. Psalm 102, verse 13. Just turn in there.
Thou shalt rise.
Yes. I'm just trying to get there myself. Please, just go with me. Yeah.
Thou shalt arise.
You will arise. Somebody say, arise.
Arise.
And have mercy upon Zion.
And have mercy upon Zion.
For the time to favor her.
The set time is come. The set time has come. Amen. Sit down. I just want to tell you the topic of today's message is, it's your time.
Amen.
Amen. But I must tell you the truth.
Amen.
Amen. Now, what preachers preach at times will tell you things as if When we say miracle, you just get it without anything. Some mothers will try and play with their young ones when they are, maybe some grandmothers, will tell their pregnant young ones that, you know what, when you sleep, by the time you get to the hospital, you will just sleep. And by the time you wake up, the baby will just be by your side. And the mom, the child will say, Mom, really? Wait till the time. It's time. When it is time for you to succeed in life, when it is time for you to prosper in life, you need what is called the power to break forth. You need what is called the energy to break forth. The energy a woman uses when she's giving birth to a child. At the point when the woman is struggling to give birth to a child, if she mistakenly punch you, you will land on the floor. It is heavier than that of Mike Tyson. Because there is certain strength they need to gather. That certain strength comes from every vein in the body. All their muscles have to be quickened for that process. That is exactly what you need when you want to break through. And the reason why you delay yourself when you want to break through is because you complain at the gate of breakthrough. You retire when you are expected to retire. Oh God. Men that retire at the gate of breakthrough will go back to where they are coming from. But men that retire at the gate of breakthrough will enter into their breakthrough. Yeah, you've been waiting for the right man for a long time. You say, okay, at the end of the day, I've waited so long. I'll just get pregnant for any married man. And at the end of the day, whatever happened, I'll just be a single mother. Is that a solution to her problem? She's adding more to her trouble. Oh, this marriage seems not to be working. Oh God. And you don't want to pray to solve the problem. Just call this thing up and remarry. Just like that. Amen. Do you know, if you say the person you married before is a lion and you want to run away from him, do you know the next person might be a gorilla? I'm talking about waiting. Isaiah 40 verse 31 says, those that wait upon the Lord. Come on. There is something that is associated to waiting on God. It is called the renewal of strength. Come on. It is called the renewal of strength. When you are waiting, the strength you have prior to the waiting time is not enough. The strength a woman takes into the labor room is not enough. She needed to gather some strength for hours. She needed to gather strength by shouting and screaming. She needed to gather a lot of strength. Then she will know it indeed the water has break forth. When she sees the water, that tells her it is time. But that is not the end of it. When she sees the water, that is actually the beginning of pain. And that is exactly what we can liken what we are going through in this world to. You don't give up. Men that give up, men that withdraw, men that cannot stand, cannot get there. One thing about life is that your opposition have a vow. Some men said, as touching Paul, they said, we shall not eat or drink until Paul's die. Until he died, they will not eat or drink. And they made this vow for 40 days. When your enemies are saying they will go hunger, they will go on hunger strike until they get rid of you. And they ask you to go on 3 days marathon fasting, on 3 days fasting. Break at 12 p.m. and say, oh, but I'm going to work on that day. And your enemies are on 40 days marathon fasting just because of you. And they are praying to God, God, do not have mercy on him. God, don't have mercy on him. God. And you are saying, I'm tired of prayer. Your strength is not enough. If you fail in the day of adversity, the Bible says your strength is not enough. I'm going to quickly take you to some levels. Before changes can happen in your life, before you can have a testimony, there are certain things that have to go. There are certain prerequisites that have to be in place. Number one thing, Isaiah 14 verse 1, is called divine intervention. Amen. Bible talks about that. I said, God, the time to have compassion on her has come. The time to have mercy on her has come. That is when God chooses to have mercy on you. James 2 verse 13 says, the Lord will judge without mercy, because where there is mercy, there is no judgment. Because mercy prevails over judgment. Indeed, your forefather might have killed so many people. Your great-grandmother might be a witch. My great-grandmother might be a witch, and she might have killed so many people. But the fact remains that when there is a divine intervention, the Bible says, so said, the blood of Jesus speaketh better thing than the blood of Abel. Come on. Even if I come from the family of Cain, which is not even the case, and the blood of Abel is screaming and shouting, I want vengeance. And the blood of Jesus says, the blood of Abel, I want you to keep quiet at this point in time. For it is written that every ordinance that has been written contrary to them has been blotted out by my own blood, which is the super blood. I have made all ordinances on the cross. I triumph over principalities and powers, and I make them a public ridicule. Therefore, you blood of Abel, I want you to keep quiet, because I have the final say. Come on. That is called divine intervention. Oh, when you hear divine intervention, then you smile, say, hey, God has intervened. Let me just relax. The moment you see the hand of God in your case is when you need even to start working for God. I liken divine intervention to when a woman sees the water. That is when you need to start working, really. That is not when you need to relax. If you get this thing right, I'm telling you, you will walk in this life with joy. Enemies will see you and they will run away from you. I want to take you to a dimension that by the time you move out of this place, you will walk before your enemies that you've been running away from before, and when they see you, they will run away from you. Yeah. Oh God, I'm going to take you there right now. Isaiah 14 verse 2 says, the Lord will give you power over your oppressors, and you will have power over those that oppress you, and you will take captive those captive who you were. People that have taken you captive, you will not take them captive. You will not arrest those that have arrested you before. Oh God. People that locked you in the prison, that says stay here. You will now lock them in the prison and you have them to stay here. Because you gather something called the strength. You gather the power that can imprison them, and you are not subject to imprisonment anymore. Oh God, that's Isaiah 14 verse 2. That is called the level of empowerment. Before there's a level of empowerment, when God comes, when God is involved in your case, God needs you to do certain things. And those things are called, Romans 8 verse 14 says, as many that are led by the Spirit of God are called the sons of God. Then when God is interested in your case, he begins to tell you, my son, I want you to wake up at night. Pray at this point in time. God, but you know I'm tired. God, but you know I'm going to work tomorrow. God, but you know it's not easy. But God, you know, I'm not feeling very well. God, I'm going to say, okay, don't worry. I was just thinking to speed up the case so you can get better on time. But if you don't want me to speed up, don't worry, I'll go back on gear one. Don't worry, let's move with slow motion. If you want slow motion, I'll let your life move with slow motion. Then if you want quick speed, then I'll let your life move with quick speed. The condition and the speed of people's life are determined by them. When God wants to quicken their footstep, they choose to walk at a very slow pace. When God decides to quicken their step, they choose to walk at a slow pace. Come on. Then they will tell them, come to a program called Night of Wonders. Come to a program called Solution Night. But you know I have exams. And maybe the enemy wants them to fail the exam, and they just, God just wants to give them solution in Solution Night. And they say, but God, you know I have exams. But come to church on Sunday. They say, but you know, actually tomorrow is my exam. So I have to be away from church on Sunday so I can have enough time to read. But mind you, the same person is in club on Saturday. And when you're saying, hey, ah, oh yes. Who is stopping who? Who is the enemy? I'm talking about the set time. Your time has come. Now, if you don't understand what you are doing to delay yourself, you'll be waiting at the bus stop for a longer time. But if you understand what you are doing to contribute to your failure, then you will stop doing it and you become a success. Life is so simple. Come on. Verse 3 says, and in those days, in that day, the Lord will give you rest.
Amen.
From what? from your fear, from your sorrow. He said the Lord will give you